If I had to venture a guess, one of them is probably going to be Unit 1 for Shinji Ikari. Because if it is really the rebuild movies and the list went up to 3.0, this means it could include Shinji nearly causing the third impact.
Yeah. Probably.
Yeah, we weren't able to stop this, and the Federation's in disarray, great. And there are people, and it sounds like, based on what he's saying, yeah, it sounds like that there were some sympathizers in the Federation Forces ranks. That is just perfect! A lot of these soldiers still carry traumas of the past conflicts. Some are involved in plant fighting, others the Lizard Wars, and others the Rise of the Outlaws. God damn it, Ribbons Allmark. There's people in the military. Everyone is really on edge and distrustful of each other. Yeah, you know what? I think this world needs Kira, Atherin, and Setsuna.
Well, they had Setsuna.
Then I stole them.
Whoops.
In my defense, I didn't steal them. His engine fucked up. They are-
Whoops.
Yeah. Okay, so contact anyone you think can help, even if they operate a little outside the law. I can think of a group that does that. I can think of two in this world immediately. There's the Archangel crew, and then there is Celestial Being. Oh, and this guy is Akito's father-in-law. He wants us to pass a message. I'd love to have another bowl of his ramen someday. You know, we're meeting so many good father figures in this series. Then we're gonna meet Gendo Ikari. Can I kill Gendo Ikari?
Please, please let us kill that man.
Actually, I'll be honest, his finale with Shinji in 3.0 plus 1 is really good.
Yeah, it only goes to 3.0.
Yeah, well, because Plus One only came out, like, I think, like, a year ago.
Yeah.
3.0 Plus One ends with him and Shinji kind of, not so much reconciling, but coming to an understanding. Shinji gets why he did all of the shit he did. Doesn't agree with it, but he understands what Gendo was trying to do. Because the way the rebuilds for Eva ends, you know, outside of destroying the angels themselves, are, it's much more akin to a Gundam ending, where it's not achieved through violence, but through understanding.
Right.
And Shinji gives a happy ending to Rei, Asuka, kinda one to Gendo, and finally lets Kuro end the story. Oh, I just realized. Oh shit, we're gonna get like the actual best girl from Evangelion now, if it's using the rebuilds. There's a third female pilot introduced.
Right.
She's batshit. I love her. Like legitimately, she is insane.
Is it the one with the pink suit?
It's the one with the pink suit.
Okay. I've only, like, seen a little bit of her.
She calls Shinji a puppy. Just because of the way he acts. Because he acts like a dog.
That's kind of accurate, yeah.
Yeah. She calls Asuka a princess. And Asuka's just great all around. She's just angry. Then there's Rey. I don't have much to say about Rey. I hope I can give her a happier ending than she had in 2.0, though. Well, actually, she had actually a pretty happy ending in overall. And Soji's staying here while we're leaving. He's not coming with us to find the Yamato. But Tatsu's gonna put him up for a while. I'm curious,
I can understand why he doesn't want to get back into this.
It's not that he doesn't want to get back into it, he doesn't want to go back to his to their world.
Yeah. Which means having to get back into it.
Yeah. It's in particular because of the fact there's no guarantee the Yamato will make it back. Especially with the amount of time we've wasted here. It was the trip to Iskandar and back by itself was by the skin of their teeth. Like, they made it, like, I think a month or so before they were out of time.
And considering all the time that's going to be spent stuck here.
Now we might be able to recover it if it ejects us closer to Iskandar when we go back.
Yeah.
Because we are assuming every time we do it, it's going to dump us back on Earth. If it does that, then we're fucked. There's no way you can make it to Iskandar and back. Especially if this happens every time we use a wave motion. I'm somewhat still convinced this was because of the gun. Okay, so yeah, we do need more people.
I do wonder, like, who could be the big cause of this?
Yeah, who's there? Who's the equivalent of the Questars?
Questars, yeah, and
who's she gonna reach out? Yes! She's gonna reach out to Celestial Being!
Gotta call in Jesus Yamato.
No, he's Orb. God, could you imagine the irony of putting Kira in Celestial Being? They're pretty good about not mixing groups like that, but I'm kinda sad because of it would have fit so well with the community's joke on them. What's wrong with that? I think it's a good idea. I don't think Setsuna and Tiara ever told us they worked for Celestial Being. But what do you know? Okay, yeah, so we've only been here for 2 weeks. Okay. Celestial Being is that group that finally put a stop to the Outlaws. That is correct. I mean, on the surface, that's not wrong. Fuck, that's canon! No! Celestial Being the movie. The start of the Awakening of Trailblazer is this, like, really weird, over-the-top anime production. It's an anime within an anime of the final battle with the Outlaws. That also, for some reason, included Access. That's weird. It's over the top. Tiara was a great. No. Alleluia was a woman. Lock-On was black, which is weird because he's Irish. That's now actually no. That one was just like over the top. That was all. maybe no, he's told his kid, but yeah, it was propaganda. Because the government was trying to... It makes sense. The outlaws were the government. They were an autonomous peacekeeping force, which only goes well. True, and also from Subway to 2199, there won't be that many movies for us to watch. And then true, we see the Braves here. I know what, I could give her that. I'll give her the assumption that that could have been seen as normal around here.
Yeah.
He's doing some stuff with the Brave Corps. Oh, no, she thought she... I'm sorry, I thought I was smarter. Fuck. Now I feel... Oof. Best feel robot. Bad. Best robot. She's gonna help with her analytical capabilities to make up for her own.
You made the robot feel dumb. Look what you've done.
No. The robot feels smart. Nine is offering to use her intelligence to boost our own intelligence. Okay, so... Oh, you want to know the history of Celestial Being? It's a private armed organization founded by Ilya Shenberg. Started armed interventions. Nearly got wiped out. Came back. Destroyed the outlaws. Went into hiding. Yep. His intentions were grand, but also very ideal. Like, his intentions were Celestial Being will eliminate war. The only issue was, it was the meme of, I will end this violence the only way I know how.
I know how. With more violence.
To the point, Lock-On Stratus points out, very early in the series, where they're ending a drug trade. I know, he wasn't ending a drug trade. He was ending, a war over mining. He was just taking pot shots at these mobile suits. Not shooting them, but shooting around them. He's like, please surrender. This feels like bullying. They were in, 20 years out of date mobile suits.
Right.
And he's in the Dynamis. Alleluia just straight up burnt down a drug farm. They actually did a lot of good, but they also messed up a lot of shit. Not saying that bad. On paper, his methods are very good. But yeah, basically they were holding the world at gunpoint, which was the purpose of Celestial Being. They would swoop in as a neutral third party and take down both sides. Celestial Being made a lot of enemies. Oh, so instead of having the economic blocks of 00... Oh shit! My microphone just fell.
Ah.
So that just happened. I was like, what the fuck was that? Okay, so yeah, that just happened live on stream.
Yeah, I actually didn't hear it on my side until the stream caught up.
Yeah, I know, because it didn't really do much. There we go. What's Scatty run off to? Aw, it's scared gamer dog.
Gamer dog, no.
It also knocked over my grandpa Gundam.
Grandpa, you've fallen.
Not the custom, and it wasn't even my custom painted one. No. It had to be the limited edition one. Whoa. What the hell?
Oh, I think you broke your neck.
Yeah, I think I did. Give me a second. Yeah, it's probably because I know why it happened. You. Ix, I had a Lumi moment. but not nearly as bad as Lumi.
Okay, so I think out of any of the worlds, Full Metal Panic is probably going to exist in this one.
I think it's going to either exist in this one or exist in the next one.
I don't think it's going to exist in the next one, because the next one is, well...
The Evas, the Invaders, the Super Robots, there's a lot going on.
Yeah, it could still feasibly work.
The one I'm curious about...
But I think it would fit better in this world.
Can I be honest?
This world seems to be more...
grounded.
Normal.
Yeah, so instead of interfering with the economic blocks, they interfered with the Zaft versus Natural War, which is not a good war to interfere in, because that was basically a eugenics war. Long story short,
deal with eugenics.
The coordinators were people who were willing to alter their DNA to basically become the best they could be. The naturals were people who said, fuck that, everything has to be natural. It's the eugenics war from Star Trek, if it actually had time to go into detail what the fuck happened.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was the anti-Earth Jupiter Sphere Alliance, Ganymede, Ganymede, Calestia, Europa, and other planetoid nations. Which is better as the Jovian Federation, which is the group we're currently dealing with. And that was the Lizard Wars.
My cat is being whiny.
I can hear it. So there was a three-way war, and then Celestial Being gets involved. Which was the Innovade. Animals were a group controlled by the Innovades. Which is goddamn Ribbon's Allmark. And it was meant to be creating innovators. So yeah, that's enough saying. So yeah. And no one knows what Celestial Beings anymore. Yeah, like, no matter what, Celestial Being has always stood by its founding principle of wanting to end conflict. And, say what you might, the chaos they brought has changed the war. Changed the world. Actually, after the second time, they did it for the better. They won't be able to. Celestial Being can't ignore this. But we know if Celestial Being has a history with them, they're gonna show the fuck up. So let's just keep fighting them. But what I saw in the movie was all made up. That probably means the gun. They're all different. I wonder how the guy in the blue one is especially.
Girl.
That's an FSA. They even give up the code names, if I remember correctly. Oh, is this a cat? She's a cat burglar with minions called cat girls. The Brave series is weird. She's got a maid. Oh, so this is the business he had to deal with. You know what's even bigger than a million? A bill. She wants to be rich, but yet she can't. He points out he is richer. I'm gonna kill her. You've got to be kidding me. I'm going to kill her. It's cat puns.
Chill out, Nick. That's not very ice.
Goddamn, the tracking didn't work. I was gonna slam my head into the side of the screen. They have Max. Of course they have Max.
Yeah.
We need to have something for us to fight. Scenario 12, Dispeller of Chaos. And this is another time you've heard the mention of a wonderful new sponsor. I have a feeling their sponsor is the Mars group, and that they're just doing this to keep us busy while they set everything up. What the fuck? Another Brave Express villain. And another one with the sponsor. Oh, he's a global arms dealer. Great. I'm gonna kill. Is it just me or does he look like a character from Ed, Edd n Eddy?
There are many doors, Ed boy.
There are many doors, Ed boy. He looks like Ralph. Tokyo Times bestseller. Really. It's quite the big surly man too. Somebody, I swear to God, if it's that girl again. Okay, she has to be doing this on purpose.
What if she's the sponsor?
My God! She's causing all this chaos just because she likes him.
Teddy.
What it means to be a hero. It's just like that last part with Gridman. Everyone. But this is what it means to be a hero. Everyone but Ryoma. Ryoma's not a hero. He's just a psychopath. I gotta defeat 8 enemy units in 4 turns. Come on with a missile barrage. Gotta hope that there are other people out here who are going to be willing to help us. As usual, celestial beings gonna be, that's still only gonna be possibly 4 machines, possibly 2, if depending. Because I don't know if Setsuna and Terraria are with them. The Setsuna and Terraria are still on the Yamato. Celestial beings only at half strength. I don't see them digging out the manga for this. Let's try this again. Might as well put some damage to the other ones. Okay, what the fuck is Gravity Blast? I'm curious.
では作戦行動を継続します。
Oh! Okay, just a fuck off laser. One more. One more. Ooh, I got intuition. 10,000 bonus mastery. Oh, 10,000 bonus points. Let's see what's gonna happen next. So, I might have a problem, Sean.
Yeah, I see that. They can just warp them directly around your ship.
Yeah, I'm in trouble.
Maybe this is how they captured the Yamato.
No, it sounds like they just got the teleportation tech. That sounds like it's new. Assuming the Yamato wasn't in... Well, the Yamato wasn't in good condition when we warped.
Yeah.
Because we don't know what to do. Good shot. Precision fire from afar. So in other words, it's a sniper. Palomayo said, wait a second. One of those machines isn't a Celestial Being Gundam. I know that mobile suit.
Hmm.
It looks like our pirate kid has found his way here.
Har Flipperty D.
Lock on Stratus. Alleluia Haptism. The Devil of Quanta and Raphael have been confirmed. We've got Tobiah here. Then we've got Crossbone. I'm not. This is kind of their MO. How'd you send them a message?
They've interacted in the past.
Yeah, and they quasi-hacked Veda. Veda's a quantum computer. Well, it's a quantum processor. Like, I'm just playing that because that's impressive. Oh, they gotta go back the hard way.
They came all this way just to get their asses kicked. It's so considerate of them.
And it's a good show, time to show off the return of Celestial Being. And they also brought the Ptolemaios too. Jeez, is the Ptolemaios high at this point? Oh, it's, they're calling the Ptolemaios 2 custom. Gotta work through the remainder of these guys, then my main force can wind up with Celestial Being. So it seems these machines are kind of like the other ones from their universe that I have on my team. They're really fast, but all their other stats are hot garbage. You know that kind of makes really good at fighting them? Mobile, like, specifically Gundams, because if you tune the Gundams, the Gundams have a higher sight. Oh, into the fact that they are, you know, easy to use. Why does everyone want my Vangray?
Go after the weaker one, bitch.
They all want... No, you know what they all want? They all want 9. Boss of the Asian Mafia.
I'm not gonna mention how stereotypical he looks.
I mean, they hit all the hell, they did a stereotype even of their own culture.
Yeah.
I mean, how we do it with our villains, too. There we go, one more machine down. There are many doors now open, Ed Boy. A lot of people like Evangelion. Yeah, no. I'll be honest, I like the rebuilds. I do think Ava has some very interesting mech design.
Eds would probably be good getter robo-pilots. You know
they
what?
They probably would, right. Actually. They meet the requirements. They're all insane.
from just watching Armageddon, yeah, they definitely would.
Ed would be the most endued with the Getter race.
Oh, well, definitely Ed with a single B.
But also, yeah. They're... The other ship's on their second captain, just like Celestial Beings on their second lock-on.
Out of the three of them, Ed is the most insane one. Ikuze, Haro!
I had seen Sigurora work well, I just had never had the opportunity to play it until 30 games.
Ever since then, you haven't looked back.
Kinda, yeah. And then this one was just like the fact that, oh, it's in English on the Switch. Most of us just simply like dealing with English patches. I'm getting yelled at to release the Hound of Brackness.
Really, release the thought, the hands.
Release the brat! Ugh. Imagine Ed as an Ava pilot. I don't think it would be that it would be in Berserk mode all the time. I think it'd just reject them.
No, you know what? Double D. Double D as
double,
pilot.
Double D I could see as an Ava pilot.
Specifically because he's got the insecurities of...
Yeah, you have to be insecure in some way, shape, or form to be an Ava pilot.
I mean, Edge can be insecure about things too. He just doesn't show it a lot.
You need major hangups to be a day of a pilot.
And like, we've seen everything that Double D has to offer with his insecurities. Double D best at boy. Change my mind.
Okay, let's see. Activate Trans Am!
Gundam to kill you.
Unless it's canon, but the planets are older, so you might not adjust it.
Oh, yeah, that's, right. Because I'll be honest, my knowledge on Ava is spotty. I know of some of the spinoffs, but I don't know a lot. As I'll check. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought it was. Yeah, because Anima is a slightly altered version of Evangelion.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, but it changed certain events. I think the reason why we don't see Anima is because it's not official. I don't believe it's officially licensed. Because, Evangelion Anima was not created by the original creator of Ava, as far as I know.
Light novel.
Published, but I don't think it's I'm not seeing if it's officially
created by Ikuto, Yamashita, and Kara. Written by Yamashita, Ikuto. And Takeru Kageyama as writers. And Yasuo Kashihara was planning an editor.
Yeah, I don't know if it was commissioned by Anno.
There have been some stuff, some Anno stuff in DW, which is not in the mainline games. Okay.
Yeah, DW is where they seem to throw a lot of the stuff that they aren't too sure is going to stick well. It seems like in general, they don't use Ava that often, to my knowledge. Because I know it's in this one. And this one, I think they used mostly because the rebuilds were a thing. That's mostly what it was about.
Let's see. Yeah, normal Evangelion only appears in... Am I only seeing Alpha, Alpha 3, and MX?
Because that's Neon Genesis Evangelion, not the rebuilds.
Okay. But they also appear in Z, so that's one.
Oh yeah, Well, Super Robot Wars Z was before I believe 1.0 was a thing. So... That, and I get why they don't use Ava a lot. Ava's, if you're not doing long that multiversal travel, like I'm assuming Z is, and this one.
Not many weapons can effectively work against Angels in Ava.
Yeah, it's just the thing, Ava doesn't play well with other rules. A lot of the others you can work with. Ava's just hard. And it's like, oh, the Avenge Ballistics appears. They dropped an N2 mine on him. Like, they blow him up constantly with N2 mines and they don't do shit. Then there's really only so much you can do with Ava. Like, SR.
At least in Super Robot Wars Z, C1 gets him to grit his teeth.
Yeah. I get they use Ryoma a lot, same with Amuro, but they usually try to do something with them. Like, for example, Amuro knowing Ryoma kind of made him a better Gundam pilot. Nothing against Ava. I think Ava's a perfectly fine. I think Ava's rebuilds are. To be honest, I kind of like the rebuilds better. Well, for I think you're talking about Simon making him grit his teeth. Shinji
yeah,
needed
it's so good.
Neon
so
Genesis
good.
Evangelion Shinji needed that. Like, legitimately, he needed.
He also gets right slapped in the Z timeline.
He needs both.
He does need both.
Like, that's something I kind of liked about the rebuilds, that Asuka calls him out on the shit. It's like, you got problems with your father, deal with it. That's neat. If you're in chat, one of us will probably check it out when we have time. We don't know anything about Kikade, Ryoma, or Tetsuya, so...
We've still got allies missing in action.
Yep. We can assume they're all on the Yamato. They're just bullying this poor girl. We either forget everything and live in this world, or we could all confront the truth together. Yeah, that sounds like Sumeragi. Sumeragi Lee Noriega does not. You know, that's the thing, if I could be perfectly honest, I like Evangelion more in the Super Robot Wars universe because of the fact that they're around more well-adjusted pilots who call them out on their shit. Because the whole point of Ava is they're all messed up and Gendo wants them that way. Because it's all part of the plan. He needs them to be fucked up. Especially Shinji. Just kind of, it. Granted, it's also a bit of, from my understanding, a bit of a reflection on Anno's mental state. It's why he apparently gave Rebuilds a bit more of a hopeful ending, because he's it. From my understanding, he was not in a good place when he finished Evangelion, but he was in a much better spot when he finished Neon Genesis. Yeah, no, Nerve and Seal are basically cults, except. Actually, I never finished Neon Genesis Evangelion proper. It just, some stuff dragged way too long. I found Shinji to be too infuriating. Just a whole bunch of reasons. I think the Evas themselves are really neat mech designs. But I couldn't get through it. I did watch all the rebuilds, though. I actually thoroughly enjoy the rebuilds. Oh, yeah. Haptism Mari Parfacy. Yeah, no, from my understanding, Getter Robo and Evangelion were both very much influenced by Super Robot Wars' depictions of their characters. Ryoma, in particular, saw a lot of changes after Super Robot Wars. To a point, from my understanding, some of his traits from SRW were actually incorporated into Armageddon.
Makes sense. When a character gets enough of a change in a separate set of media, it becomes the preferred version.
It wasn't even so much of a preferred version. The writers just took bits. They didn't take, like, you know, full traits whole hog. The Ken Ishida, the creator of Getter Robo, did the same thing when he was writing the original manga. Musashi and Benkei didn't really have characters at first. They were very much Toei Animation's creations, but he liked some of the stuff they were doing with them, so he started to incorporate it into his manga. Getter's manga and TV show were running along the same time. Just, its manga is way bloodier and a lot more cosmic horror. Because Ken Ishida was really into that shit. No. Mazinger was a TV show before. Oh no, Mazin Kaiser, my fault, no, I misread that.
The robot, specifically the Mazin Kaiser robot.
I don't think so. I think Mazin Kaiser was a movie first. It was made around the same time as Getter Robo. My fault, I misread that. I'm not wearing my glasses, I should mention.
Nope.
Mazin Kaiser
is a Japanese anime OVA produced by Brainspace and Dynamic Productions based on the Mazin Kaiser design that debuted in the Super Robot Wars game.
So Mazin Kaiser was based off of the design.
And the original Mazinger Z manga by Go Nagai.
Who is also best friends and co-author of Getter Robo. So, Mazin Kaiser, okay. Yeah, no. I don't have my glasses on, so I see Mazin. I'm like, okay, Mazinger? Yeah, I can't read small text. Like, I have the game screen blown the way the fuck up so I can read it. I'm trying to think here. More DLC stuff. Let's go see what's going on in the factory. Ooh. By analyzing your combat style and life-saving maneuvers, we've gained another 100 attack points. I like this system. I actually do like her gaining attack points from just observing the team. Ah, yeah, we just finished Dinozenon.
Dinozenon! Dinozenon!
There is a movie coming out, actually. I forget if it's 2022 or 2023 they've announced it for. I think it's set for late 2022 as of right now. Which is going to be, Gridman and Dinozenon, since, you know, they're from the same origins. That was a good romp there, actually, with, Gridman. I really did like him in SR30. Especially if you have, if you get Ultraman with it, the actual interactions between the two are great. I remember, when Ultraman, Gridman characters saw Ultraman, they actually just acknowledged the Giant of Light. We're both just like, what the fuck? Oh, she's done it. She's managed to make Setsuna speechless. Missed out on finally meeting Ultraman, their progenitor.
There's always potential for them to meet up in a different Super Robot Wars game if there's ever another opportunity.
I was about to say, there's probably going to be another SR game.